We're given f of x equals the quantity 2 minus 3x raised to the fourth. We want to find the critical numbers, then determine the intervals for which the function is increasing or decreasing. So for a quick review, to find the intervals for which a function is increasing or decreasing, step one is to find the critical numbers or critical values of the given function. And then we'll use these values or these numbers to determine the test intervals from the domain of the given function. Step two, we'll determine the sign of the first derivative in each interval, where if the first derivative is positive or greater than zero, the function is increasing over the interval. And if the first derivative is negative or less than zero, then the function is decreasing over the interval. So the first step is to find the derivative function, see where it's equal to zero or undefined. Notice to find our derivative function, we do have to apply the chain rule, where the inner function would be 2 minus 3x. So if we let u equal 2 minus 3x, notice u prime or du dx would be negative 3. And since u is equal to the quantity 2 minus 3x, we can now rewrite the given function as just u to the fourth. And therefore, f prime of x would be equal to 4 u to the third times u prime, or 4 times the quantity 2 minus 3x to the third times negative 3, which would be negative 12 times the quantity 2 minus 3x to the third. We'll notice how the derivative function is a polynomial function, which will never be undefined. So to find the critical numbers, we'll set this equal to zero and solve for x. So we want to know when negative 12 times the quantity 2 minus 3x to the third would be equal to zero. Well, this will be equal to zero when the factor 2 minus 3x equals zero. So to solve this equation for x, we would subtract 2 on both sides, giving us negative 3x equals negative 2, dividing both sides by negative 3. Notice how x equals 2/3, which is our only critical number. And now because the domain of the given function is all real numbers, we'll divide the number line using the critical number 2/3. So for example, if this number line represents all real numbers, we would divide it using the critical number 2/3. Therefore, the interval on the left would be the open interval from negative infinity to 2/3. The interval on the right would be the open interval from 2/3 to infinity. If we wanted to, we could say when x is less than 2/3 or when x is greater than 2/3. Now we'll pick a test value in each interval and determine the sign of the first derivative. So for the interval on the left, let's select x equals 0. So we'll evaluate the derivative function at x equals 0 and determine the sign. Well, here's our derivative function. So we'd have negative 12 times the quantity 2 minus 3 times 0 to the third. That'd be negative 12 times 2 to the third, which would be negative 12 times 8, which would be negative 96. We don't really care about the exact value here. We just care that the sign is negative, and therefore the first derivative is negative over this entire interval. And therefore, the given function would be decreasing over the open interval from negative infinity to 2/3, or when x is less than 2/3. And now for the next interval, let's use x equal 1. We can use any value of x in this interval, but x equals 1 should be fairly straightforward. So now we'll find f prime of 1, which would be negative 12 times the quantity 2 minus 3 times 1 cubed. Here we'd have 2 minus 3, that's negative 1. So we have negative 12 times negative 1 to the third. This would be negative 12 times negative 1, or positive 12. So if this value is positive, the first derivative is positive over this entire interval, and therefore, the given function is increasing over the open interval from 2/3 to infinity, or when x is greater than 2/3. Let's go ahead and verify this by looking at the graph of the given function. It's a little hard to tell, but right here is where x would be equal to 2/3. So notice on the open interval from negative infinity to 2/3, or on this interval here, the function is decreasing because as x increases, the y values decrease, or we can think that we're going downhill from left to right. And when x is greater than 2/3, or on the open interval from 2/3 to infinity, notice how the function is increasing because as x increases, the y values also increase, or we can think about going uphill from left to right. I hope you found this helpful.